Y'all may have to bear witness. I was honored to be asked to speak as a friend. And I said, if he has so many friends, if I took one word from everybody, we'd probably be here all night. John was a very dear friend of mine. John, Johnny, Dad, White Boy, whatever you wanted to call him, he was loved by all. I got to thinking about the way we met. Some 44 years ago, about the time in season playing football, I was lifeguard here at the pool in Hudson, and I ventured down Main Street. Not looking for John, because I didn't have any interest in him, but he had a sister named George Adams. So I think that's really how it all started, Georgiana. But Georgiana was pretty smart. She went this way. Me and John, we went this way. But we became friends at that time, about 2 years between us. When I graduated from high school, I went to work that summer at the experiment station out here for Dr. Paul Backman doing his trials on peanuts. And there was a group of boys out there working in the summer. They called them the hoe boys. They were either hoeing, pulling weeds, picking peaches, picking up trash, whatever Henry Ivy decided they needed to be doing. During that time, Henry asked me, he said, you're going to have to get some help to help you do your project. So, of course, I looked over there and I told John, I said, come on, you can work with me this summer. So that was probably the summer that we really got to be close friends, working together every day, swimming in the afternoons, rambling all weekend, coming home for brisk fetus lunch. And from that time, we just remained friends like you'll never have. John loved to fish, he loved to hunt, loved to do all things like that. I guess the biggest problem and the biggest difference between me and John we had was he was an Alabama fan. So we knew where each of us stood on that side. He might say Roll Tide and I'd say War Eagle, but we'd let it go at that. Even though we have had some heated conversations in the past about that. John loved all people. It didn't matter. Old, young, black, white, it didn't matter. He would help anybody. He'd help you without asking. If he knew there was a need, he tried to cover it. I went through good times with John, bad times. A lot more good times than we had bad times, whether it was my bad times or his. And our friendship prevailed. He loved his family. Beth, Chris, Cutting, Caleb, Georgiana, the whole crowd. I mean, that, you know, he might not show it sometimes, but I knew it. And, you know, there was a lot of discussions me and him have had that y'all never know about. But he was very proud of y'all, proud of the boys, proud of what they're doing with their lives. They're turned into fine young men. I'm proud of them. He was just a real personal guy. Just about a day doesn't go by that I didn't talk to him. Might be just a second on the phone. Might be just pulling through the yard, never get out of the truck, let the window down, what you doing, what you working on. Always had something going. We're all gonna miss him so much. Someone asked me, said, well, what story are you gonna tell? I said, well, I don't know how many, because I know there's a lot of them I can't tell. I won't tell. He loved his dogs, Ringo and Milo. When this tragedy hit on us Thursday, went up Thursday night, just couldn't believe what was going on. Stayed up there till about 3:30 Friday morning, got up, didn't know what to do. Went back Friday morning, sat all day for what seemed to be an eternity. Saturday morning, I got ready to go back, and I was going to pick up Adam Smith, his cousin that lives next door to him. When I turned in the driveway, the dogs know me so well that they put a beeline to my truck. I know they thought he was in there with me. John always had a wooden cross around his gave some of these out. If you got one, you were special. I didn't get one. My daughter got one, but I didn't. One of the stories about his dogs was when Ringo was in the puppy stage, John was sitting in that recliner at night, Ringo getting his lap, sleep, whatever. One night he fell asleep. Ringo was sleeping in his lap. He woke up with about 100 toothpicks on his neck where the dog had chewed the cross completely off his neck and left.